morning students. Here we'll start with another topic, formation of quadratic polynomial if zeros are given. In the previous lecture you have already learned how to form a quadratic polynomial if alpha and beta are the zeros. Quadratic polynomial is equal to k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x. Alpha plus beta is the sum of the zeros, plus alpha beta, that is product of zeros, where k is a non-zero constant, which means k can be any value other than zero. To understand this concept, we will do some examples. Example 1. Form a quadratic polynomial if zeros are 2 and 3. Given that two zeros, 2 and 3. Let 2 will take it as alpha and 3 will take it as beta. So, what is alpha plus beta? Alpha plus beta means 2 plus 3, that is 5. What is alpha beta? That is 2 into 3 is equal to 6. So, the general format for quadratic polynomial is that k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. That is k into x square minus alpha plus beta, that is 5 into x plus 6. That is x square minus 5x plus 6 if k is equal to 1. That means if two zeros are given, then we can find the corresponding quadratic polynomial, that is x square minus 5x plus 6 if k is equal to 1. Example 2. Form a quadratic polynomial if zeros are 2 and 3 by 2. So here we'll take it as 2 as alpha and 3 by 2 as beta. So alpha plus beta is equal to 2 plus 3 by 2. We'll take the LCM, that is 2. So it becomes 4 plus 3, that is 7 by 2. Alpha beta is equal to 2 into 3 by 2. So 2 and 2 we can cancel out, that is 3. So quadratic polynomial is equal to k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. That is k into x square minus alpha plus beta, that is 7 by 2 x plus alpha beta, that is 3. We can take the LCM. What is LCM? LCM is 2. So it becomes 2x square minus 7x plus 6. So 2x square minus 7x plus 6 if k is equal to 2. That means if the denominator of it is 2, then we will take the value of k as 2. So automatically k and 2 will cancel out. So here the polynomial is 2x square minus 7x plus 6. Example 3. Form a polynomial if zeros are root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3. Here also this will take it as alpha and this is beta. Alpha plus beta is equal to root of 5 by 3 plus minus root 5 by 3. So 1 is positive, 1 is negative, so the sum will be 0. Alpha beta is equal to root of 5 by 3 into minus root 5 by 3. When we multiply these two, we will get minus of 5 by 3. So, quadratic polynomial is equal to k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. That is k into x square minus alpha plus beta, that is 0, into x alpha beta, that is minus 5 by 3. Here the second term is 0. Now we have to concentrate only the first term and the last term, that is x square minus 5 by 3. That is k into, we'll take the LCM, that is 3x square minus 5. That is 3x square minus 5 if k is equal to 3. That means k is a non-zero constant. In the first example, the value of k was 1. Second example, k is equal to 2. And the third example, k is equal to 3. That means k can be any non-zero constant. Now we are going to solve some important questions from this chapter, polynomial. This is very important question, that is question number 1. Find all the zeros of the polynomial 2x raised to 4 minus 3x cube minus 3x square plus 6x minus 2 if two zeros are root 2 and minus root 2. And here the polynomial is biquadratic, so it has 4 zeros. Out of 4 zeros, 2 zeros are given. The remaining 2 zeros we have to find. For that, what are the concepts we learned till now? All the concepts should be used to solve this question. That much important question it is. So here we'll start. Here this is alpha and minus root 2 as beta. So alpha plus beta is equal to root 2 plus minus root 2. So sum is 0. Product alpha beta is equal to root 2 into minus root 2, that is minus 2. So quadratic polynomial is equal to k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta, that is k into x square minus 0 into x minus 2, that is k into only first and last term, that is x square minus 2. So x square minus 2 if k is equal to 1. That means if two zeros are given, using that two zeros, first will form a quadratic polynomial. Now what you have to do? Now we have to divide the given quadratic polynomial by this quadratic polynomial, that is x square minus 2. 2x raised to 4 divided by x square, that is 2x square. 2x square multiplied by x square minus 2, that is 2x raised to 4 minus 4x square. We'll change the sign, minus plus. Minus 3x cube plus x square plus 6x minus 2. Minus 3x cube divided by x square, that is minus 3x. Minus 3x cube plus 6x. We'll change the sign, plus minus. Then x square minus 2. So x square divided by x square, that is 1. 1 into x square minus 2. Minus plus, that is 0. That means if we divide properly, for every question the remainder will be 0. And it is a biquadratic polynomial, 2 zeros are given. So we have to find out the remaining 2 zeros. For that, equating the quotient to 0, that is 2x square minus 3x plus 1 equal to 0. This is a quadratic polynomial, so we can split the middle term. For that, sum is minus 3, product is 2. The numbers are minus 2 and minus 1. So 2x square minus 2x minus x plus 1 equal to 0. So we can take common, 2x into x minus 1 minus 1 into x minus 1 equal to 0. That is x minus 1 into 2x minus 1 equal to 0. That is x minus 1 equal to 0, or 2x minus 1 equal to 0. That is x is equal to 1, or x is equal to 1 by 2. So 2 zeros are root 2 and minus root 2, and the remaining 2 zeros are 1 and 1 by 2. These are the 4 zeros of this polynomial. Question number 2. Find all the zeros if 2 zeros are 2 plus or minus root 3. What is the meaning of 2 plus or minus root 3? That means 1 zero is 2 plus root 3, other 0 is 2 minus root 3. This will take it as alpha, this will take it as beta. So alpha plus beta is equal to 2 plus root 3 plus beta, that is 2 minus root 3. So when we add, root 3 and minus root 3 will cancel out. So sum is 4. Alpha beta is equal to 2 plus root 3 into 2 minus root 3. This is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. What is a plus b into a minus b? That is a square minus b square. So 2 square minus root 3 square, that is 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. Quadratic polynomial is equal to k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. That is k into x square minus 4x plus 1. That is x square minus 4x plus 1 if k is equal to 1. Now the same way we will divide this polynomial by x square minus 4x plus 1. Now we divide this polynomial by x square minus 4x plus 1. We will do the division in such a manner. So we will get the quotient as x square minus 2x minus 35. Here also we have to find out the remaining two zeros. For that, equating the quotient to 0. X square minus 2x minus 35 equal to 0. That is, sum is minus 2. Product is minus 35. Numbers are minus 7 and 5. Using these two numbers, we will split the middle term. We will do the procedure the same way. X is equal to 7 and x is equal to minus 5. So, find all the zeros. What are the zeros? One is 2 plus root 3. Second one is 2 minus root 3. Third one is x is equal to 7. And the fourth one is minus 5. These are the four zeros of this polynomial. Try to do these two assignments. First one, find all the zeros of the polynomial x raised to 4 minus 3x cube minus x square plus 9x minus 6 if two zeros are root 3 and minus root 3. Find all the zeros of the polynomial 2x raised to 4 minus 2x cube minus 7x square plus 3x plus 6 if two zeros are root of 3 by 2 and minus root 3 by 2. Stay home, stay safe, and break the chain. Thank you.